وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Allah Azza wa Jal said, when your Lord declared, if you show gratitude, I will surely give you increase. And if you are ungrateful, then indeed my punishment is severe. So we have to show gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal for the blessings of our family. And the question then comes, well, how do we show gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal for the blessings that He's given us, the blessing of the family that He's given us? And perhaps we can quote the ayah in Surah Saba, which is ayah number 13, in which Allah Azza wa Jal said, اِعْمَلُوا آلَ دَاوُدَ شُكْرًا وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشُّكُورِ. Act, O family of Dawood, in gratitude, and how few of my servants are truly grateful. So Allah Azza wa Jal commands us to act in gratitude, commands us to perform actions, to do things that show our gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed us with a family, being part of a Muslim family, then there's no doubt that this is something which deserves gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal. It's a ni'mah of Allah. We don't want to be like those people about whom Allah said, أَفَبِالْبَاطِلِ يُؤْمِنُونَ وَبِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ هُمْ يَكْفُرُونَ. Is it the falsehood that they believe in while they are ungrateful or rejecting of the blessings of Allah? And also we want to show by putting it into practice, by striving to make our families the best that they possibly can be. At-taqwa, having taqwa. And that's because taqwa is really the building block which a Muslim builds everything upon, including their family. So if you were to kind of have a single word that would summarize what you want from your family dynamic and what you want from your household, it is at-taqwa. It is at-taqwa. And at-taqwa, as some of the scholars defined it, they said, it is al-amalu bi ta'ati Allah ala nurin min Allah raja'a thawabi Allah wa tarku ma'asi Allah ala nurin min Allah makhafata 'adhabi Allah. That it is to act in obedience to Allah upon a light of guidance from Allah, hoping for Allah's mercy, and to leave disobedience to Allah upon a light of guidance from Allah, fearing Allah's punishment. So to do your best to obey Allah, and to do your best to keep away from disobeying Allah. O mankind, have taqwa of your Lord who created you from a single soul, and created from that single person, Adam, his mate, Hawa. And from those two, all of the men and women came. And have taqwa of Allah, الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ, the one that you ask by him. So you say, wallahi, or you say, billahi, as'aluka billah, I ask you by Allah, I ask you by Allah to do this for me. You ask Allah by it. Wal arham. And here, if we read arham with a fatha, then the meaning here is, be careful, fear Allah with regard to your relatives. Fear Allah with regard to your relatives. Inna Allaha kana alaykum raqiba. Allah is always watching over you. Allah is always watching over you. So this ayah contains, first of all, it tells us that Allah Azza wa Jal began this entire, not all of Bani Adam, Allah Azza wa Jal began this entire human race out of just two people, out of Adam and Hawa, the first Muslim family. And then Allah Azza wa Jal tells us the rights that our family members have over us. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ. Have taqwa of Allah, the one that you ask by his name. And fear Allah with regard to your relatives, and indeed Allah is ever watchful over you.